Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's your brother Yahya Ibrahim with another Ramadan therapy. Alhamdulillah, we've been studying some of the dua of the Prophet ﷺ that he would select from the Quran or words he would teach to those who would ask him for assistance in times of need and difficulty. And this particular dua, this is dua number 7. Allahumma barik ya Rabb, Allahumma lak alhamd. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our Ramadan, to give us many, many more opportunities to find therapy in it, healing in it, and to make it a closure for those things of distress in our life that we seek to find, to come to an end. This is the hadith of Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu wa arda. Now, Abdullah ibn Abbas is related to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was a young man. The Prophet made lots of dua for him in particular, and he said, Allahumma allimhu ta'wil. Oh Allah, give Abdullah ibn Abbas an understanding of the Quran, its meanings and its dictates and its practice. Abdullah ibn Abbas lived for a long period of time where he was able to give victory to Islam and the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was a reference point in understanding the word of Allah after the demise of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his return to Allah azza wa jal. May Allah join us with him in the highest levels of Jannah. Abdullah ibn Abbas, he said, كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يدعو عند الكرب. Abdullah ibn Abbas, because he's related to the Prophet, he used to be able to come into the household of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when other Sahaba couldn't. So he could sit with the Prophet ﷺ in the evenings, in the nights, in the mornings, in the days. He was a person who was privy to the inner life of the Prophet ﷺ. Also, he was young in age, so he was able to see things for a number of years and a number of different occasions, not just snapshots. He didn't travel away from the Prophet ﷺ. He wasn't out working, buying and selling. He was free in his young age to study and receive tutelage from the Prophet ﷺ. So when he gives you this dua and he says that the Prophet ﷺ used to say it often whenever distress would arrive, means you should pay attention to it. So this becomes one of those central dua that you and I need to know about how to alleviate harm, distress, things of feelings of foreboding, physical distress, financial distress, all of those things that are considered karb. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yafukka karbana, Allahumma ameen, that he undoes whatever harm or distress that we are facing. So the Prophet ﷺ would invariably say, often in his life, La ilaha illallah al-azim al-halim. He would say, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, La ilaha illallah al-azim al-halim. He would begin with the testimony of faith, with the shahada, which is La ilaha illallah, kalimat tayyiba, the greatest, most beautiful word, the blessed word. La ilaha illallah is khayru ma qala an-nabiyyun wa qultum. It is the best statement that anyone has said, including the prophets of the past and our Nabi and what was taught to us. It is the central focus of our tawheed, of our theology of faith, of singling out only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the more you repeat it, the better off you are. La ilaha illallah. You will find many of the foundational hadith, many of the foundational verses in the Quran are built from this statement. Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum. You'll find that the greatest verse in the Quran, the first that we studied as the very first dua of our series, begins with that statement. La ilaha illallah. It is nafyun wa ithbat. It negates all aspects of worship of anything other than God and establishes only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Illallah, only Allah will I turn to in worship, which is the basis of our faith, the basis of the Quran, the basis of the Fatiha. Iyyaka na'bud wa iyyaka nasta'in. Only you, Allah, do I worship. Only you do I ask for help. And in that statement, La ilaha illallah, four words, you establish both. Nothing will I turn to, nothing will I seek support from, nothing will I ask for help or assistance, nothing will I believe has any power or benefit of harm or good for me, illallah, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because he is al-azim al-halim. He is the almighty. Al-azim. La ilaha illallah al-azim. But also al-halim. The one who is patient in his dealings with us. And the word halim comes from that word hilm, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a forbearance for us. He allows us to make our mistakes and return to him. He gives us time to readjust. He, in all of the circumstances in our life, he is gentle with us. And therefore, the best of translations is that he is gentle in his forbearance, in his patience over us. He is al-azim, the mighty, the greatest, the one who's capable of doing and establishing what he orders, But he is al-Halim subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the one who gives us an opportunity to adjust ourselves. La ilaha illallah al-Azim al-Halim. The word Halim here, it implies that the Prophet ﷺ is teaching us that we know that there are indiscretions in our life that are the root cause of our distress. And therefore the Prophet ﷺ wants you to know that Allah is the Almighty and He can extract and exact whatever He seeks of us, but He has hilm of us. So if you truly believe in La ilaha illallah, if you understood La ilaha illallah and you know His might, then know that whatever patience Allah has given, has dealt with you is as a sabur with His hilm. Do not take it for granted. He is Al-Azim, Al-Halim. La ilaha illallah. The Prophet repeats it. La ilaha illallah. No one is there for me to worship except Allah. Rabbu samawati wal ard. The Lord of all that is in the heavens and the earth. And therefore whatever pain I have is part of this heavens and earth. Whatever is I believe is too much for me or others to fix, Allah is able to fix. Whatever harm is I believe too great, it can be undone with His power, with His love, with His mercy, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rabbu samawati wal ard. La ilaha illallah al-azim al-halim. La ilaha illallah rabbu samawati wal ard. He is the Lord of the heavens and the earth, the only governor, the only sustainer, badi'u samawati wal ard, the innovator, the creator, the one whose existence brought about the existence of the heavens and the earth, rabbu al-arsh al-azim. He is the Lord of al-arsh, the most mighty in its magnificence. Subhanallah, the hadith of the Arsh, and I don't like to translate it a throne, we don't want to give this kind of anthropomorphism. The Arsh of Ar-Rahman is a creation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has established for Himself. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ala al-Arsh istawa, He says in many places in the Quran that He has risen above in His majestic presence, in that which befits His majesty, above His Arsh in a way that is distinct from anything of His creation or of His created beings. He is unique in Himself subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when they would ask the Prophet ﷺ about Al-Kursi, in Ayatul Kursi and Al-Arsh, there are narrations where the Prophet ﷺ says that all of the heavens and all of the earth, everything in existence, all this multiverse and universe is like a ring in its size thrown in the openness of the desert. Imagine the Sahara Desert, you throw a ring in it. All of the heavens and the earth are the size of this ring compared to the Kursi, which is in that magnificence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's creation. So imagine the Arsh of Ar-Rahman. The Arsh of Ar-Rahman, the Prophet ﷺ says, and the Kursi is like a ring in comparison to the Arsh. So if all the heavens and all the earth fit into a ring size of the Arsh, imagine what the Kursi is compared to the Arsh. The Arsh is so magnificent in its presence, in its establishment. And above the Arsh, in a manner that befits His majesty, having might and power and authority over all of His creation, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. رَبُّ الْعَرْشِ الْعَظِيمِ. He is the Lord of Al-Arsh, which is Azim, which is beyond description in its magnificence. This is a dua that would be said by the Prophet ﷺ at any time of difficulty. It reminds him of the greatness, the power, the authority of Allah, the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in my life. Remind us who we turn to in help and assistance, who we seek our blessings and assistance from. I repeat it for you. The hadith is in Sahih al-Bukhari and I will share it in our links insha'Allah. La ilaha illallah al-azim al-halim. La ilaha illallah rabbu al-samawati wal-ard. Rabbu al-arsh al-azim. The Lord of al-arsh al-azim. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove our pain and harm and make us from those who are blessed in this dunya and akhirah. Join us with النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين in جنة الفردوس مع نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. وآخر دعوان الحمد لله رب العالمين وتقبل الله مني ومنكم صيامنا وقيامنا وركوعنا وسجودنا في هذا الشهر المبارك شهر رمضان أهله الله علينا مرارا وتكرارا. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.